Hello and welcome to the world of recipes. I'm Vaishali. Delhi is famous for its food and Delhiites are famous for their love for food. There are so many restaurants in Delhi who are offering delicious food. Today we are going to make Delhi's famous chicken recipe, chicken korma. So let's see the ingredients. One small chicken, it is about 750 grams. 3 to 4 medium sized onions. Yogurt about 1 cup, and these are 15 cashews soaked in hot water. We need some whole garam masala here, 8 to 10 cloves, 2 to 3 cinnamon sticks smaller, cardamom pods about 6 to 7, black peppercorn about 15, javitri and nutmeg. And we need some ground spices here. This is coriander powder, about 3 tablespoons. Ginger garlic paste, 1 tablespoon. Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 tablespoon. This is spicy red chili powder, 1 tablespoon. Turmeric powder, 1/2 tablespoon. Cumin powder, 1 tablespoon. Garam masala, 1 tablespoon. Salt according to taste. I have taken 1 tablespoon of salt here. And oil for frying onions. Let's start with the recipe now. Begin this recipe by frying onions. Make oil hot in a pan. This is the most important step in making korma. We need to fry this onion till it becomes light brown. Don't overcook them, otherwise your korma will become black in color. Now you can see this onion has started turning brown. 1 or 2 minutes more and it will be done. Now this is done. We'll remove it. Take out excess oil. Now we'll keep this aside and let it cool down. We need to strain this yogurt so that we get smooth yogurt here. Now this yogurt is smooth. We are going to add all these dry masalas in this. Red chili powder, Kashmiri red chili powder, turmeric, jeera powder and this coriander powder. And mix it well. Now this mix is ready. We need to cook this recipe in a vessel with a smaller mouth so that all the aromas retain inside. I have this cooker, so I'm going to use it to cook korma. We'll add ghee to this cooker. This is a very rich recipe, so we need to use ghee only. Now this ghee is hot. We'll add this whole spices in this. Cinnamon sticks, cloves, cardamom pods and peppercorns. Now roasted this spices in ghee. Now we'll add this yogurt. Lower the glass flame. We need to cook all these spices on a low flame. You can see so much ghee in the recipe. Now lower the gas flame and cook it on a slow flame for about 5 minutes. In the meantime, now these onions are cold. We'll add these cashews to it. And we'll add about 1 tablespoon of yogurt. And grind this mixture in a blender. Now I have taken this onion mixture in the blender. I'm going to grind it till it becomes fine paste. Now this onion paste is ready. And you can see our yogurt mixture is also cooking. It's been 5 minutes now. So I will add ginger garlic paste to it and let it cook. It will take about 1 to 2 minutes for ginger garlic paste to cook. You can see a lot of bubbling happening here. This is because our yogurt has a lot of water in it. Let this bubble settle down. Now this bubble formation is reduced. That means the water from yogurt has evaporated. Now at this point we are going to add this onion and cashew mixture. These onions are already cooked and cashew doesn't need cooking. So we have to just mix it with the spices. Now this onion mixture is mixed properly here. Now we have to add this garam masala and salt. Mix it well. And now adding chicken pieces to this gravy. Mix the chicken pieces well with the gravy. As you can see, this is a thick gravy. We are going to add little bit of water, but korma gravy will be thicker only. As we have to keep this gravy thick, we'll add little water, sufficient for cooking of chicken. Now we need to cover this handi and let it cook about for 20 minutes on a slow to medium heat. Now it's been 20 minutes. Let's check the chicken.
Wow.
We need to check whether the chicken has cooked properly or not. Yes. I think the chicken is perfectly done. At this point, I will add this javitri on top and some nutmeg powder. And again, I will put the lid for 2 minutes to get that aroma of nutmeg and javitri in the chicken. Wow, you can get that aroma of nutmeg now. Now just turn off the flame and it's ready to serve. This yummy chicken korma is ready. Enjoy it with any kind of roti, chapati, naan, or any kind of bread or rice. I'm sure you're going to love this recipe. For such more delicious recipes, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this recipe.